Bing. I decided just on a lark that I'm going to read to you the first three pages of my new fiction, which is called Mitzi Boyarsky Floating. Let's see how this goes. I have to read it from the computer screen. The day Mitzi Boyarsky decides she likes strawberries is the same day she finds out she's dying. Just a coincidence, but that's not how it feels. The ice cream shop shares a parking lot with a weight loss clinic, an Italian restaurant, and the medical building where her nephrologist works. Having just heard that her tenure on Earth is up in 6 months or less, Mitzi deemed it wise to treat herself. She's had to wait in line, as it's also the last day of school, and the place is choked with teenagers. Mitzi never liked teenagers, even when she was one, but lately she's developing a morbid fear of them. The classic rock station on the boombox is blaring an old Van Halen song. The ice cream man nods his hairnet in tempo. He passes her a cone of something pale pink. She says, I think I asked for chocolate chip. What? Speak up. I wanted chocolate chip. Then why'd you ask for the strawberry swirl? I didn't. Are you calling me a liar? Mitzi blinks. That's a stumper. She takes a breath and summons all the assertiveness she can remember from that self-help paperback about how to get doctors to listen to you. Question, why would I ask for strawberry when I hate strawberry? How should I know? Maybe you're one of those compulsive mindfuckers. Someone behind her sighs. The voice on the radio says, go ahead and jump. It's just another little death, she reasons. Just one more thing you may not have your way. Not worth raising your blood pressure over. Holding her strawberry swirl cone, Mitzi walks out into the heat and greenness of late June. There's a cute designer trash receptacle beside a wrought iron park bench. She considers tossing the ice cream straight away. Instead, she sits watching it until it begins to dribble over her fingers, then resolves to taste the thing, if only to spite it. As it touches her tongue, a car alarm sounds not far away. It's not that bad, really, strawberry swirl. Grows on you after a few licks. The tangy wrestles with the sweet, and then you get this weird sort of lightness in your mouth. It only takes a few minutes to eat the whole thing, by which time she's stopped crying and someone has turned off the car alarm. Jesus, girl, leave some for the rest of us, Tammy says 2 weeks later at the house on the lake. Mitzi's been mindlessly helping herself to the strawberries in Auntie Kiki's antediluvian enamel colander. Now she draws her hand back in horror. Sorry, I'm like 100% elsewhere. Tammy flicks her two long bangs back and gives her a look and returns to chopping the ends off green beans. I'm starting to worry about you, Mittens. I mean, is something going on or what? The breeze picks up off the water, and the bamboo wind chimes bonk, bim, bonk outside. Mitzi arranges the collection of flower-shaped green strawberry hats on the table in front of her. There are 1,000 ways to put off telling your sister what's going on. I don't have a job in September. The library didn't renew my contract, which happens to be true. She's being let go for excessive absenteeism. Now you tell me, 6 hours in the car, you're all hangdoggy and not a word about what's eating you. What's eating me? My immune system is eating me. She doesn't say it. No point burdening Tammy or her friends with this crap. The screen door slams behind Trimble in his trunks, dripping a trail of water across the floor to Auntie Kiki's refrigerator. You guys ought to come in. The water's great. The beer can hisses as he cracks it, and Mitzi glances at his shiny abdominals. I'll be down in a little bit, her sister says. What about you, sexy? Coming in for a swim? Mitzi looks him in the eye. I'll see how I feel. You put on a little weight, Mitz? He asks. Trimble, you're a dickhead, says Tammy. Just asking. Mitzi nods. Yeah, I'm definitely retaining fluid lately. My circulation is not so good in this heat. Maybe you should see a doctor, the boy says. Tammy turns to watch Trimble's butt as he goes out the door. Well, that sucks. She picks up where she left off. Okay, that's enough for now. I hope I make more progress.